More than one in three people have prediabetes, but 90% don't even know they have it. Now, prediabetes is reversible, so it's important to know so you can get the proper treatment. It can become type 2 diabetes or cause other serious problems like kidney disease, even blindness. So joining us to share how important it is to prevent this is our diabetes expert, CEO of Lysulin, Dr. John Burd. It's great to have you here. So let's talk about this. I mean, more than one in three people have this and don't know. Why is that?
Well, it's only diagnosed if your doctor happens to run a blood test when you see your doctor, and it's diagnosed with a blood test, and it shows you whether you don't have diabetes, you have diabetes, or you have prediabetes. It's kind of a stepping stone, normal prediabetes, diabetes.
Okay, and obviously, you know, for people to try to prevent this, let's talk about what some of the leading causes would be. What leads to prediabetes?
Well, actually, you know, prediabetes and type 2 diabetes is a diet disease. And the diet disease happens because we have so many carbohydrates in our diet. And we have the government with that silly diet pyramid that they made back in 1980, showing that we should eat 80% carbohydrates and low amounts of fat. That's just totally upside down. And when you eat carbohydrates, you get glucose in your bloodstream from them. And that leads to all the problems because glucose, we need it for energy, but it's toxic. And you need to not eat so many carbohydrates, sugar, and high fructose corn syrup. Those are the things that cause diabetes. And fortunately, you know, I'm happy to say I'm CEO of Lysulin. We have a nutritional supplement that can stop that reaction that happens in your body when glucose reacts with all the proteins in your body.
So you're saying not to eat donuts and, you know, cake and bread all day long. But if people do become diagnosed with prediabetes, what can they do about it? Is there a way to reverse? What are you suggesting people eat instead?
Yep, but actually, you know, it's not a one-way street. You don't have to go from normal to prediabetes to diabetes, because if you can improve your diet by lowering your carbohydrate consumption and add supplements to your diet like Lysulin, which prevents insulin resistance, and insulin resistance is what causes high blood sugars and type 2 diabetes and the complications of diabetes. So you can definitely do something about it without the need for prescription drugs. So I hope people will look into that. And, you know, we have clinical studies that prove what I just said is true. I'm not just making this up. Mm-hmm.
Now, I liked what you said. I was reading earlier that being diagnosed with this prediabetes is kind of like a fork in the road. You can choose, you know, what you want to do with it. It's not, you know, your future is not destined to stay that way, right?
Yeah, it's not a one-way street. You can reverse gears and help yourself to not get diabetes just by diet, a little bit of exercise, maybe some fasting, intermittent fasting, and supplements. They can help you to get off that diabetes street.
Mm-hmm. And Dr. Burd, you've had an interesting background with this. Why are you so passionate about helping people with diabetes?
Well, I was actually named after an uncle who died of complications of diabetes. And as I've aged, like all my other family members, I have many family members now that have unfortunately developed diabetes, and they're being helped with these natural products. So my mission now is to find natural solutions to big healthcare problems without the need for prescription drugs. So, and diabetes is like the black plague of the 21st century. It's a pandemic worldwide, and there's no need for it. If we just would change, the government would change diet recommendations, we could get on the right path and become virtually diabetes free. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease.
Right.
That's another story. But type 2 diabetes and prediabetes, there's no need for that, because if people would just change their diet, they could eliminate type 2 diabetes on the planet, like smallpox and polio.
Okay. Yeah, definitely need to be mindful about what we put in our mouths. It's that simple. So, all right. Dr. Burd, thank you very much for joining us.
Well, thank you so much for having me. It's my pleasure.
All right. Take care.